Nessa Mvula Vinaka, happy Easter. Well, it's less than 24 hours away from the big fight. Yes, everyone's excited, between Joseph Parker and Anthony Joshua.
That's right, and joining us this morning is boxing trainer Lolo Heimuli. Very good morning to you, Lolo. How are you?
Good morning, guys.
Yeah. Thank you so much for joining us on the Pulu Kalama this morning. Now, what does Joseph Parker have to do to win this massive fight?
Well, he's got nothing to lose, hasn't he? I mean, I'm pretty sure a lot of boxing experts probably rubbish him because of his last four performances. But, you know, a lot of people don't realise that Joseph had elbow injury. Not just one, but both of them.
Both of them.
And just as being a boxing coach, when you when you fight at that level with injuries, imagine when you don't have one. Yeah. So I think he's injury free for this one. I'm looking forward to it.
Absolutely.
Do you think that will be playing on the back of his mind, though? Will it?
Well, yes and no. Yes, is that he'll remember the injury, and two, he knows that he's no longer there. You know, it's play a lot worse on you when you don't get it fixed.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But now it's all fixed now, and you know. It's very exciting.
Well, I must say, I've really enjoyed following schools in Samoa. Now, they've been coming up with chants, you know, chanting for Joseph Parker. And even last night, there was a service out in Mangere supporting Joseph Parker, all the way from little old Aotearoa, and they're all the way in Cardiff. And what would you like to see, win or lose?
Well, I would like to see Joseph win, of course, you know, but, you know, it's a tough sport, and this is the... It can't get any bigger than a heavyweight boxing, you know, title of the world. Mm-hmm. This is it. There's nothing bigger than this.
Do you think it's the right time in Parker's career for this fight?
Yes, I mean, it's been 5 years. He's been fighting, you know, work his way up to the top, won the WBL title. But, you know, if thing doesn't happen to him, he's only 24 years old, you know. He would get a few other chances later on, where some of the other boxers in the past, like you saw Ortiz last time, he fought, he was nearly 40 years old, and, right. You know. And he didn't get his shot until he was, you know, in that age. But Parker is only a baby, you know, and you know, they've done a great job with him, you know, both Dugo and Kevin Barry, you know, to get this fight.
What does Parker have that Anthony Joshua doesn't have?
I would give Parker the speed, you know. I think Parker has the superior hand speed over Joshua. To be fair, I think Joshua is a lot stronger than Parker. But if Parker can find his range and get inside and unleash those, you know, those hand speed, anything can happen.
There's been, I guess, a lot of support. We've seen a lot of people who are travelling over to Cardiff for the fight as well. What has this fight done for Pasifika boxing?
Sorry?
So what has the Joseph Parker fight done for Pacific boxing?
I mean, a lot. I mean, this is just another icing on the cake. Ever since he won the WBO title, he's already helped the growth of sport back in the island, not just in Samoa, but Tonga also in here. So I think most people go to Cardiff to show the appreciation, pretty much like how the MMT, you know, have all sort of Tongan all around the world came in to support. I think that's, you know, they don't care if Parker win or lose. Most of them going there to support a brother, you know?
Absolutely.
And even Mark Khan and also come from Australia, you know?
So the result for the fight, what are you predicting?
Well, if I was a betting man last year, I would have bet on Joshua, you know? But I just found out recently about his elbow operation that we didn't realise that he was fighting under enormous amount of pain. And that's got fixed. So, yes, I'll stick with Parker. I hold my heart rather than my boxing.
Thank you, Lolo, for joining us on the studio.
My lot, Peter Lolo.
Thank you.